Jack Tri Stadium near the banks of the Skunk River plays host for this matchup. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. TCU has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 26-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. He's to the 40, and he's taken down at the 42. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
He airs it out, and he hauls it in to the 20. Touchdown, Iowa State. And he hits the PAT. So a short three-play, 74-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys got to be coming over the sidelines after touchdown saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. He's scrambling, and he's going to come up with a sack.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
From their own 22-yard line, it's second down. Tries to buy some time. They'll make the sack.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
Gets it out quick, and it's going the other way. And they make the stop at the 21.
The defense really cranked up the heat there. Give those guys all the credit for forcing a desperation pass.
From the 21-yard line, first down. Iowa State is up a score. Montgomery, the ball carrier, and down he goes at the 22-yard line.
Let's go! Let's go! Mike 42, Mike 42.
They come out on an empty backfield. Scrambling around. And he's tackled in the open field. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. He scrambles, tries to get around the corner. Looks like he's going to run. Touchdown, Cyclones. And he converts the extra point. with a three-play, 21-yard drive, and the result, 7 points. The Cyclones lost one of their key guys earlier to that injury, and unfortunately, I don't think he's going to play any more football today. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Brad, as good as this defense has looked, I'm not necessarily surprised by this shutout. I mean, you and I were there on Wednesday watching this team practice, and when this first-team defense goes against their own first-team offense in a practice, sometimes it's actually better than the game itself. So they've prepared themselves very well to have this kind of game.
Oklahoma, Oklahoma!
Quick throw, almost intercepted.
Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. And he just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He throws left. They'll bring him down around the 44-yard line.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
He steps out at about the 47-yard line. He goes out of bounds at about the 49. Nice catch, first down, and he's knocked out.
Wide receiver's role in a play-action pass is to get into position and to hit his spot in timing and rhythm with the quarterback. And that's exactly what they were able to do on this last play. You realize you've got a little bit more time because of the play-action, and it gives you more time to get to that point that the quarterback's looking for you to be at, but make sure you do a good job of selling your route and getting in position to give an open target for the quarterback. How about the big fellas up front? This line will have to continue to play like that to build the consistency to help this offense be effective.
Steps out of bounds at the 19. Second down and 7. Ball on the 19-yard line. Caught, open field, and they push him out around the 12-yard line.
Watch the run, watch the run. Seven's a mic.
Touchdown, TCU. He makes the PAT. A 10-play, 74-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
The score now, 14-7. He's to the 20, makes it to the 22-yard line. Iowa State's a team that was supposed to roll over and play dead in this football game, and they're not doing that.
I think what we've seen so far is some good execution, but just more of an attitude. They have shown up to play in this game with a confidence and a belief in one another that they're going to pull off an upset today.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Iowa State is up 7. And he's tackled right around the 26-yard line. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackle around the 49-yard line.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
He's on the run. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. Slides down. Room around the corner. He gets hit out of bounds at the 14-yard line. He's scrambling. He's tackled right around the 12-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. Tackle made around the 11-yard line. It's third and seven. Ball on the 11-yard line. Quickly, and he's got his man. He's pushed out of bounds
at about the 5-yard line.
Epps picks him up 6 yards with a catch.
Two times. Four down.
Iowa State up 7 points.
Let's go. Red 85.
Tackle for a loss, and they'll turn it over on downs. So they turn it over on downs, and that's a big boost for this defense.
In a close game like this one, it's big plays like this that can be the deciding factor. Now, the last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this drive.
They get him in the backfield for a loss. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here.
That's what I'm talking about, baby.
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Knocked out of bounds around the 39-yard line.
Man left. Four down. 42 spot.
The scoreboard lit up in that first 15 minutes. Iowa State in front, 14-7. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two.
Larry.
Iowa State is up by a touchdown. Now he's scrambling, and they get the sack. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
So that sack will back him up a little now. They're looking at a difficult third and 13. Fires out to his wideout. He's taken down right around the 30. Iowa State is hoping to make this a two-score game. It's up, and he nails the long field goal. They line up to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Fires out quick. It's picked off. He's into the open field. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown.
Great job here by the defender breaking on the ball and taking it to the house. Man, those pick sixes can really hurt an offense and have a lasting impact.
And he adds the extra point. Francis is lined up to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Let's see how the defense responds now, coming off that big play just a moment ago.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off of mistakes.
Brought down at about the 35. Quick, he's got another one, and he's taken down
at about the 43-yard line.
We gotta get to the ball, team. We gotta get to the ball. Let's keep moving.
Takes a handoff, tackled for a loss. There was just no daylight on that play, and the defensive lineman was the reason.
Well, that's one way to get involved in the game. Great stop in the backfield.
From their own 40-yard line, third down. Now he tries to buy some time, and he can't get away from the pressure. Nunez is the punter. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. The Cyclones looked almost unstoppable in that first quarter, and Herbie, since then, it's not so much that way.
Yeah, they've been sluggish here in recent series, but I think it's important. They still have the lead. This is where some leadership needs to assert itself, and somebody needs to make a play to flip that switch to get this offense going again.
And he carries the ball for a nice game. He's got an opening.
The thing I love about this guy is he can throw the ball, he can run it, and that's hard to stop.
He's out of bounds around the 47-yard line. Catches it, gets out of bounds. And he tackles him hard at the 29.
Delayed handoff. Runs right for a nice gain. Second down and 7 coming up here. Ball on the 25.
Ready! Wide 50! Easy! Rally!
Scrambling around. And he's sacked.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
Here's the 8th play of the series.
Hey, Mike's 42. Larry. Hey, watch number five.
Under heavy pressure. Back-to-back sacks.
Well, if they keep putting pressure on him like this, he might start to look to get rid of the ball quicker, which could very possibly lead to turnovers.
Fourth and long here after the sack. Kicks up, and he splits the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout.
He scrambles. Now he's going to run and watch out. Dives for extra yardage.
Hey, watch the ball, watch the ball. Mike seven. Disco Raver.
They make the stop right around the 38-yard line.
Well, that's just a good call from the defensive side of the football. They know what this team likes to run, and they got the better of them that time.
A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. And down he goes around the 48-yard line. Pitches back. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line.
Here we go.
Clemens and Mike.
Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. And they hit him in the backfield. Loss of a yard.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
From midfield. Second down. Big hit, he stopped in his tracks.
Mike seven. Quad.
Check down.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen.
They'll bring him down.
Right around the 40. A 5-yard gain.
They executed the screen play well here by getting the ball to the halfback. They pick up some yards.
Fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit. The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Iowa State's put themselves in a great position now as they head into the second half.
Well, in the first half, we saw a lot of big playability and just an explosive approach by this offense. But remember, we'll see what happens here in the second half. This is a long way from being over.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being.
Knocked out of bounds at the 26. Montgomery picks up 6 yards with that grab.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Looking to scramble out. He can't get away from the pressure.
You know, Brad, that time the defense brought the blitz, and I think it confused the offensive line. It's one thing to pick up the blitz, but you also have to be accountable for the defensive lineman. That time the lineman got to the quarterback and came up with a sack.
They try running left, and they get nice yardage on that run. The Horned Frogs using their third and final timeout. Downing is waiting for the snap. Oh, excellent punt. He's at midfield. Tackle at the 48. Pretty good job by the return man there. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Short over the middle, and he hits him hard at the 45. And Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
Throws this one out to the right.
Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 26. Throwing right. Looks to the end zone and it's caught. Touchdown. Wow, an almost impossible pass to defend, and it goes for 6.
Yep, the defense would have needed 12 guys on the field that time.
And he tacks on the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He'll take it from the 2. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. The defense really shut these guys down the last time they had the ball. Nice run up the middle. Iowa State just took their first time out. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. Goes over the middle, intercepted. So we've played 2 quarters. Iowa State in front, 27-14.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. Both of these quarterbacks took several hits in the first half, the pass rush having its way with the protection so far. Now, everybody says, throw some screens at them, slow down the pass rush. Does that really work in the defensive mindset?
No, it does, because, you know, as an offensive lineman, they're still going to set the same and make it look like pass, and you naturally just fly up the field to try to go get the quarterback because you've been doing it all game, and then you slip in a screen or you slip in a draw right behind them. It makes you think, and it makes you honor that. You know what else helps, Reese? You run the football a little bit. I mean, you pass it a bunch. I know a pass is coming. I mean, it makes it pretty – that's pretty simple. Defensive guys are hitting the head a lot, and they're not the brightest, but they do know that. You keep doing it, we're going to keep pinning our ears back and coming back after the quarterback.
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half while the game's going on?
Yeah, I'm going to kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kirk.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Nice run there. After a decent run up the gut. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He steps out at the 40. It to the halfback on the screen. And he's tackled around the 45-yard line. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. Nunez awaits the snap. And down he goes at the 25. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Tackle made around the 24-yard line.
That's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm established, and for such a negative play to happen, loss of yards, that can really have a negative impact on the offense and what they're trying to do.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. Gets it. He's in space. That's a great tackle at the 32-yard line. Tackles him for a loss. That's not going to move the sticks.
Yeah, this defense played some sound football out there and did a good job of not letting him get into any kind of rhythm.
They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. Booming kick. He gets hit out of bounds. Around the 36-yard line. Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here.
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Got it and brought down immediately. That quickly incomplete. From their own 41-yard line, third down. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. He's tackled at about the 47-yard line. throw. Incomplete pass. From the 47-yard line. Second down. He's scrambling. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. Dives, and he's down. He's on the run. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. He's at the 20. Decides to slide. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back. That one's going to put him way back.
You just can't block a player from behind like that, or it's going to cost you.
From the 40-yard line, first down. They come out in an empty backfield. He chucks it downfield. Got his receiver. Touchdown. Kirk, that was a beautiful pass and a nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly. And again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
It was a pretty simple route, but they run it to perfection for the score. He makes the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Payne fields it at the 2. He's taken down at the 26-yard line. The Cyclones fans have got to be going crazy. It looked like they had this one in hand or could put it out of reach, and they haven't been able to do it.
This is a tough game for the fans to watch because their team was so dominant early in the game, and now they've just gone cold, and they've allowed the opponent to get right back into this game. They better find something here to be able to try to get out of here with a win.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He's taken down at the 35. Iowa State with a 6-point lead. Tackle at the 44-yard line. Up the middle for a nice gain. Around the 47-yard line.
Watch a slap, watch a slap, watch a slap. Mike 42, Mike 42.
They bring him down in the backfield. Let's see if he aims for the sideline and tries to get this thing down deep in their own territory. And he's got to be happy with that punt, Kirk.
Yeah, Brad, that was nice. And now they're looking at a long way to go to even think about a score.
The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
A 7-yard play.
That's a good completion. They didn't get the first down, but they picked up about 7 yards.
The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Throws to the fullback. They can't hook up. Incomplete.
That's exactly how they drew it up in the sideline, and now they get the ball back.
Nunez is the punter. Yeah.
And he's taken down at the 39-yard line.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none. They don't want none of this.
Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive. Iowa State up six.
Now he tries to buy some time. And he's sacked. They'll line up with five wide receivers. And he's taken down around the 49-yard line. Brought down around the 50-yard line. Nice run, and he's brought down. And it looks like this one's going to come down to the final quarter. Iowa State's lead is six. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Early in the fourth quarter, if that stop and a play like that might be the momentum swing this team needs to win it. He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Fires out to his wideout, and down he goes, around the 26-yard line. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen, and they make the stop at the 31. Out and he's going to get sacked. Second down, and they've got 15 for the first down. Ball on their own 26. He's scrambling. They bring him down. And look who comes up with the sack. It's the freshman.
Typically at this point in the game, you'd expect your seniors to step up.
Fires that quickly to the tailback. They'll bring him down at about the 21. Noonan is waiting for the snap. They'll bring him down at the 43-yard line. A score here might effectively end this one. Iowa State is up by six. Got an opening. He gets out to about the 44-yard line. Tries to scramble, but he's sacked.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. And that's what happened there.
It's second down, 15 to go.
Yeah, let's get a sack on.
Ball on the 49.
Mike's 42!
He gets rid of this one. To punt.
He was able to deaden that kick perfectly, and it gives them a long field to work with.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Steps out of bounds around the 10-yard line. Austin gets him about 3 yards with a completion. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Tackle made around the 20-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
There he goes.
Zips it to the back. Quick strike to the receiver. Very good tackle in space. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. He's knocked out of bounds at the 34. From their own 34-yard line. Second down. He's going to try and scramble. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. So the play of the day, fourth and ball game, and the defense comes up with the stop of the day and what will be the win. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Gets to about the 34-yard line. A 1 yard gain by the halfback. It's second and nine. Ball on the 34. A little over a minute in the game. And they'll bring him down behind the line.
He just never had a chance to get any running room. The defense was on him almost as soon as the ball was snapped.
Watch the pass.
Caught with room to work.
Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close. Fourth down. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. It has the distance. And he nails the long field goal. Francis ready to kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. And he's hit immediately. And he stops the clock with a spike. Third down, six to go. Ball on their own 29. Here's a screen pass, gets it to the back. He tackles him for a loss. Well, that one should do it. A fourth down stop here late in the fourth quarter, and that should be the nail in the coffin in this game. And the defense comes through. They put some points on the board in their last drive, and they'll start this one in position to do much of the same.
The defense has their backs against the wall here. They're really going to have to get aggressive if they want to keep the offense from scoring any points here.
From the 31-yard line, it's second down. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. If you're an offensive coordinator, you love this play. His quarterback will take a knee. And so that's going to do it. The Cyclones come out on top, 30-21. So that wraps things up for us, for EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.